on a Friday. Props to me.
It is 5:48 on a Friday morning and I am going to work out. I don't know what's gone into me, but I'm loving these early morning workouts. And I can't work out today, probably not tomorrow. So I had to get my workout in today. It's freezing cold, but I'm gonna go do 45 minutes and then call it a day.
We are here. Okay.
I look stunning right now. Hi guys, so let me double check this. So I'm going to revitalize
here.
Because we want to. So don't at me. Rule number one, if it's about me,
at me so I can see.
Renegade, wait.
Aaron.
Here's your Vita
size. Okay, ma'am, you're gonna have to drive your car.
We went to our Vita size and we got a muffin and we got two Maca Power smoothies, which are the best. Are you all right? Mm-hmm. So good. They're having a promo right now for December. You buy one, get one for $1 and they're like $11. So we did that.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, amazing. I'm better as a boy. I've been kind of shitty as a man.
Okay, we're gonna go now. Good morning, happy Saturday. It is 8:12 a.m. Not going to a workout, which is typically why I would be up at this hour on a weekend morning. But I actually slept at my cousin's house. I was babysitting last night. So, going to get some bagels for breakfast. It's not nice outside, like, at all. But yeah, let's go get some bagels. Hopefully turn this rainy, gloomy day around to something better. But yeah, that's Saturday. This is probably one of my favorite bagel places in Thornhill. Bagel Nash, it has like Montreal style bagels, which are my favorite. So I love coming here for bagels. They're just the best. Like, who doesn't love Montreal bagels? They're honestly the best. When you're out of eggs and have to get some, let's do this. We also, because we're sitting at our aunt's house, we don't have the milk we want for coffee, so I got the milk and I got the eggs. Let's go.
Get a fork, I'm hungry.
We both got veggie bowls, which are the bomb. So good. Good?
Good.
Right? It's not that spicy. This is what-
Let's build this house so we can trap in it.
Like, yeah, that. We are building a gingerbread house tonight. It's gonna be fun. Who actually eats gingerbread houses? Nope. Yeah. Yeah.
The story that the we're focus, gonna tell the with our focus. Is about the resiliency of people from New Orleans. We're going to do
a- Can you move for a sec? My hands get so dry and cracked, I need serious relief. That's why we come
around and I'll check in and then we can-
This is the house. That's my stunning roof, stunning queen side. The house is about to fall apart. Mom, turn it off. Mom, press the same button. Mommy? Mom, press that button to turn it off. Press it. The red. Press it to turn it off. Happy Sunday. It is 8:49 and I have an F45 class booked at 9. So vlogging right now isn't the best idea. I have to go to Yorkdale. I know it's a disaster on a Sunday and like the holidays are close, but I just really want to return my items that I ordered online, and like the whole shipping them back thing is just annoying. And I guess that's an excuse to go to Yorkdale. So I'm gonna do that. And then I have lunch plans. I don't know what I'm filming. And then I have an event at 5, which is called Dinner of Miracles. And what it is a dinner with Holocaust survivors. I've never been to this event before, but I've heard only the most amazing things about it, as you can imagine. So I'm very, very, very excited for that. I'm really looking forward to that. I'm sure it'll be a very inspiring yet emotional evening, but really, really looking forward to that. So let's go. I'm super cozy right now. I'm wearing the Sunday sweatshirt by 8x1. My friend Ariella Sharf is so talented in everything she does, and she just made this sweater with the most beautiful meaning behind it. I'll link it in the bio. So Ariella, this sweater, keeping me cozy.
on this Sunday morning.
Okay, let's go. I'm gonna be late, and that's not a good look because we don't like being late. Let's go. Yeah, that was ridiculous. Lighting is bad, but worked out. I vlogged that. Came home, showered really quickly, made a quick protein smoothie, and now we are off to Yorkdale. It's going to be hell. It's going to be very, very busy because it is the holiday time. Yeah, so time to go to Yorkdale. I have a big box back there to return because I bought really ugly things on Black Friday. So I'm gonna go return that, go to Sephora, and that's it. Let's go. Oops. In Laleen, best store ever. It's my favorite in Israel. Just picking up some items because the whole store is 40% off. So I'm gonna take advantage of that. Vlog, I can't even express the stress I just experienced for a solid minute. I couldn't find my camera. I checked my purse. I was like, oh my god, I left it at the mall. I left it somewhere. What a panic. No, it was just in my Zara bag because I wanted it to be easily accessible when I was vlogging. Oh my. That was stressful. Anyways, home now from the mall. I went to Yorkdale. I went to Yorkdale earlier. Then I came home. I went to lunch with a friend. I went to Bagel. Didn't vlog that. Went to Hillcrest Mall. Didn't vlog that. Now I'm home. Finally. I feel like I've been all over the place and it's only 3 o'clock, literally. But yeah, I just went to Yorkdale. I'm actually trying on one of these tops. I have an event tonight I told you guys about earlier. So I bought this top. It's actually very nice. My mirror is not hung yet, so it's a little short, but it's this really pretty blousy top. It has like green little leaves. I actually didn't even notice the print until now. But I think I'll wear this tonight. Not too sure. It was a cute top. And then I went to Laleen, which you saw. I will show you what I got. I actually pulled out the first thing. So I've been obsessed with Laleen forever, ever since I went to Israel. I don't know, like 5 years ago. Laleen has been my favorite forever. It's like body creams, mists, scrubs, like bath bombs, everything. They have everything you need and the scents are beyond. So I have so many creams that I've just had from trips to Israel. And then finally they came to Canada recently. So I obviously want to stock up on some things. They were actually having 40% off today. So it was like a great day to go in and get some stuff. I love the scents like vanilla patchouli. They have pink, I don't know, vanilla patchouli, musk is really good, ocean's really nice, but this is the first time I've ever purchased the fragrance or scent frozen pear, and it is so amazing. It's like a crisp, like fruity, but not too fruity. It's like more like a, like literally a frozen pear. It's like fruity, but it's not like overpowering. It's really, really nice. Yes, so I bought that. So I bought the body mist, which smells so good. I already put it on today. Love it. And then I got the body cream. Yes, I have a teddy bear. It's not gonna focus. And then I actually got a hand lotion and vanilla patchouli, which is also my favorite scent, but I still have some more of the body cream in this one. So I decided to get a hand cream version of it. And then as well, I got, what's that? Oh, I got two hand sanitizers. I got frozen pear in a hand sanitizer, and then I think vanilla patchouli. And vanilla patchouli and a hand sanitizer. They were $1.50. They're usually $10, which is like a little bit much for a hand sanitizer, but so good. This is my little Laleen haul. All the packaging is just so pretty. The store is stunning. It smells amazing. And yeah, I decided to get a couple of those items for myself because why not? And that's really it. I didn't spend too much time in the mall because I don't need anything. I didn't want to shop. I really didn't need anything from Zara, but I figured I saw this top right in the front, so I quickly tried it on and I loved it. I'm gonna relax now. I have to leave for the event in about an hour and a half, so I'm gonna just chill out a bit because I'm tired and I haven't stopped running around all day, and then I will get ready for the event, even though I already have my outfit, so that'll be nice. It's movie time. We are going to see Jumanji. Oh wait, I haven't been here in so long.
Me either. This is ridiculous.
Wow.
What flavor should we choose? What do they have?
Salt and vinegar.
What is that? Doesn't even say
sour cream and onion, dill, pickle, ketchup, salt and vinegar.
Which one's that?
Oh, white
salt and vinegar.
I don't care. They should.
I remember those chairs.
Yo.
Oh my god.
Stop. Ready for Jumanji.
Other extra snacks at home. Cheap bath.
This is hitting the spot.
for dinner, we got A&W's. Is it A&W's? A&W Beyond Meat Burger in a lettuce bun. How is it? Yeah. Delicious. It kind of looks weird and is a disaster to eat, but it's good. Yes?
What? Good morning. Happy Saturday.
I think I went to bed last night at like 10:30 and I woke up at 8, so it was a really, really much needed sleep. I haven't got like a full 8 hours of sleep in so long, and I got more. So, feeling very refreshed. Going to work out. Have to just eat a little something. Banana.
I'm trying some new skincare. I don't know if my skin is reacting to it or if I'm just having breakouts. I'm trying to figure it out, but it's not looking so clear, but that's okay.
I am back home now, snacking on a Revita-sized muffin. So good. And making a coffee,
of course.
I have my almond milk frothing over here, and then the espresso is pouring. I'm gonna just hang out for a bit and then go get the nails done. I am back home now. Got my nails done, this beautiful color. No, I need to show you, hold on. I am obsessed with this color. You can't even really tell. It's like a dark gray bluey. I'll show you in better lighting next time, but it's beautiful. The color is called, I actually write down all my nail colors. It's called Susie and the Arctic Fox. It's an OPI color, this is shellac. I'll show you in better lighting, but it's beautiful. This is the first day in quite some time that I haven't had to start the car. It's like beautiful, sunny, mild out. What a beautiful Sunday. I worked out this morning at 9 a.m. Now it is 11, I have showered. Going for breakfast now with some friends at Whatabagel, classic. And then have to run around some places, get some souvenirs because today's the first day of Hanukkah. Happy Hanukkah. And yeah, just hang out. I don't even know, I have no plans, I love it. Just gonna enjoy the beautiful day. And yeah, let's play some tunes and then head off to Whatabagel for some yummy breakfast because I'm hungry.
Hey.
Hey.
I'm at Starbucks with some friends, Sloan and Leanne. Hello. And yeah, I got some souvenirs for an Instagram. Literally pay $5 for an Instagram. It's gonna be cute. And yeah, happy Sunday. Okay, we are doing a souvenir taste test right now. We just went to my Zadie's and got all of these souvenirs. We have lotus, we have tiramisu, we have, I think it's a regular jam, we have apple, we have a double caramel, and we have a cookies and cream. We are going to try these, definitely not consume all of these, but we are gonna try these out. Lotus is what we went for because lotus is like the best thing ever, so. Oh yes, okay, let's try these out. We are back with another, that just hit my head. We are back with another holiday tasting, another holiday snack tasting video.
Last time we did the macaroons and now we're doing souvenirs.
Last time we did the macaroons, they were disgusting. Cause macaroons are just gross, but like souvenirs, there's no bad souvenirs.
How about
we are recording.
Are you done?
Okay, first we are going to try, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. We are going to try the lotus souvenir. If you don't know what a lotus cookie is, yeah, lotus cookie is, it's like a ginger cookie, I don't know, whatever it is, it's incredible, and they made it into a souvenir, which is the main reason we went to my Zadie's bakery, because I think that's the only place that serves this. So let's try this. Okay, we're gonna cut it. I want it. Good. This is what the inside looks like. I'm assuming that's like a nice lotus cookie filling. So that's gonna be delish. Oh my god, there's so much cream pouring out of it. Okay. Ready? Whoa, okay. Cheers. Actually, that's too much.
Lemonade too.
That's yummy. They have like a lemon taste to them.
All super yummy. Are we rating it out of 5 or 10?
Out of 10,
5.
Yeah. Like, boring. Lotus cookie's really good, but
The inside's kind of
good. The soup grenier itself is okay. But Lotus, like a Lotus cookie is a 10. Next, we are trying tiramisu.
Tiramisu.
This is what
the they all look the exact same. It's a donut with cream inside.
Okay, tiramisu.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay. Mm. I really love it.
It's pretty dry. This is pretty. That's just not rateable.
No, this is.
It's boring.
I'm not a fan.
Okay.
That is zero.
Hydration break. Next, we got like an apple pie one. Apple. So we'll try this one. You're disgusting. This is the inside of the apple one. No, it doesn't. It's not a filling. This is like an actual apple pie. It looks really good on the inside. We are trying the apple one.
It's really good.
The apple?
Yeah.
Mmm! Apple's good. Apple's good.
Really, really good.
Apple's a 6. Apple was really good because it wasn't like a creamy filling or a custard. It was like an apple pie filling. So it was nice, thick apple pieces. I like that one. I'm trying this one now. Don't know what it is. Caramel, butterscotch, something delicious. Cheers. This is a good one. This is butterscotch, right? I think this is a butterscotch. Not bad.
If they ruin the next one, I'll hurt them. This was the best one so far.
Okay, butterscotch? I agree.
8.
Butterscotch is really good.
6.
7.5. Okay, last one we're trying. We're not gonna try the jelly one because who the hell likes jelly? This is quite the thick one. It's an Oreo cookies and cream one. It's
gonna be the same.
It's a big one. I know, I don't like a creams. Okay, cookies and cream. Too much filling.
Best one. That's good.
Mmm. Oh, this is the best one. There's a lot going on here. Cookies and cream is the winner. Cookies and cream is the winner. And that was our 7,000 calorie taste test. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed that taste test. Well, now, if you're going to get soup grenier, you'll know which ones to get and which ones to not get. Aaron is burping up a storm. I am just in some Adidas, some Lululemon leggings, and just a sweater now to keep me warm until the class. Happy Monday. What a nice Monday. It's so weird that I got to sleep in, and by sleep in I mean 8 a.m. My body just woke me up. There's no chance I could sleep in any later. But so happy it's Monday. So happy to be off for the winter break. And yeah, let's go get a 9:30. Let's go do a 9:30 a.m. class instead of a 6 a.m. class, which is so much nicer. Ooh, dogs. It's been a while since we've gone to IKEA, actually. Just outside on a walk. It's a beautiful day. Yeah. Look at this stunning house. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful. Okay, today we are making cake pops. All we need is cake mix, frosting, and then I got some food coloring and some sprinkles, whatever I had at home. And it's a pretty easy process. I will film the way we make it. But yeah, yummy confetti cake pops. Let's do this. Oh, there goes the
we making cake pops.
Cake mix. Done.
Oh, baby.
Cheers. Okay, putting the cake in. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna bake it for whatever time it says in the box. And then once that is done, we are going to crumble it up. And I'll just show you the next steps. But for now, make sure you get all of that. Make sure you grease your pan. And that's it. I'm gonna get copyrighted 110%. We have baked the cake. It is nice and golden brown. We baked it for 20 minutes, but this is the fun part. Now, we literally just destroy the cake. You're supposed to crumble it up as much as possible, and then we're gonna add the icing to it, which will make it like a sticky, doughy kind of form, and then we will make them into balls. This is so fun. I've never done this to a cake. And yeah, I'll show you what I mean.
I balled the cake. What? I made it into cake balls? Not sure.
I balled the cake.
I balled the cake. Now we're gonna put sticks in it.
I checked, it wasn't an option. But you were looking and it said all the Urban Outfitters that we have.
These are some ugly cake pops, everyone. I will show you.
I am completely failing at the cake pops. I don't know where I went wrong. First of all, the sticks are not sticking in the cake pop, so it's more like
is that?
It's as you guys saw earlier, I was making cupcakes at my I was making cake pops at my sister's place. We had to leave, so I came home, brought them with me, and finished them off, but they are just not cute. Like, they look cute, sure. Like, I got some white chocolate action over here, put some white, some yogurt pretzels, some sprinkles and stuff. Like, it looks cute, but I'm telling you, they do not taste good. They're just like too sweet. And I know cake pops are literally just cake with chocolate over it, but they're just not good. I failed somewhere. So basically I'm gonna stick to cupcake making because that's what I'm good at. But besides that, these are them. They were easy to make. They just don't taste as good as like Starbucks, you know? But yeah, cute. A for effort. Now I'm experimenting making latkes in the air fryer. Good luck. Yeah, this is not gonna work out, is it? I don't know where the idea came from, but I wanted latkes, but I didn't want them deep fried because like I'm already eating 10,000 soup gagnon a day. So I decided to make air fryer ones and they're actually incredible. Like they look stunning too. Like that's cute. Like she's good. I found the recipe on Pinterest and it was so easy. So if you have an air fryer, 10 out of 10 would recommend making air fryer latkes. Good?
Yummy.
Very yummy.
I decided to make Hanukkah and Christmas cupcakes for a little thing I'm having tonight with some friends. But oh my God, this just took 2 hours. Like, why did it take so much time? I don't know how people do this as their career, but props to them. But yeah, how cute. Like, they're cute. It just took way too long, but yeah.